So then lastly, we have to figure out giving degrees for carbons and hydrogens, okay? And degrees just have to do with how many other things are attached to my object or to my target, okay? So the carbon here is given a degree based on how many other carbons they are attached to, okay? So what I do here is I say that not all carbons are the same. I'm gonna differentiate my carbons based on how many other carbons they're attached to, okay? So I'm gonna show you an example of that in a second. So basically, the words that we use for that are primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary, or these little degree symbols. All that means is it tells you how many other carbons are directly attached to that carbon, okay? Then hydrogens, because hydrogens always have one bond. Remember that hydrogens are only happy with one, whereas carbons can have a lot of different, they always have four bonds, but they could have be bonded to other things besides carbon, okay? So hydrogens are just gonna possess the same degree as the carbon that they're attached to. So what that means is if I have a tertiary carbon, that means it's attached to three other carbons, the hydrogen that's on that tertiary carbon would be called a tertiary hydrogen as well, because it's a hydrogen of a tertiary carbon. Does that make sense? So what I want us to do, I know that's kind of a lot to take in, I have these five circles. I want you guys to identify one at a time what degrees of hydrogens and carbons we're dealing with in this molecule. That's gonna help a lot for the next page of functional groups.